Benito is cut. Benito is cut. Must have got hit. Oh, he's being choked out. Benito pulls out. That's where that technique.
Technique
always comes through. Beautiful move by Tartaro.
That's that quality you were talking about.
Get over here.
My friends, I'm Oleg Tartarov, the Russian Bear, Ultimate Fighting Championship champion. And I'm 2 times world Sambo champion and 4 times Jiu-Jitsu European champion. We're gonna learn secret Samba KGB technique. What Samba is? Samba is the best style ever made in Russia for last century. We're gonna learn incredible takedown. Arm locks. And of course, you're gonna learn leg locks. I'm sure you bought this tape especially because of you guys want to understand how to do leg locks. This is the only one tape you can buy right now in America to learn leg lock stuff. And I'm sure after watching this tape, you guys will be very successful. Before we start learning this technique, I want to tell you my opinion on martial arts. Three basics on martial arts. And my friend Andrei will assist me, and he will get all punishment tonight. And I hope he will feel good tomorrow. So, what the first? First, you have to use all parts of your body, even little finger. Second, there is no free space between us. And the third, center of your weight have to be lower than center of his weight. So you are close to the earth, you are stronger. And my words has been approved by animals many, many times. Look at dog, when he bite the neck, nobody can take a pit bull off from a neck, nobody. He's very tight and he knows what he's doing. I want you guys to be like a pit bull. Okay, this is a hip throw. This is the basic of all martial arts. How we do it? The first step, your right leg going to his right leg. And together with the left leg, you have to turn your hip to his body, very close. And you remember, center of your weight lower than center of his weight. Your arms working together with your body, with your legs. What you do now? Now you unbend your legs. You already feel like he wants to fall down. I turn my arms and he's here. And finally, you will be able to finish him by arm lock. Lovely. This is several different way to do a hip lock. First time we did it with this hold. You can do it this hold. What you need to do, just this arm has to work more powerfully. So also we can do by this hold. Also we can do by this hold. Also you can grab his gi or jacket, whatever, and do by this hold, right here. And another way to do same throw, like first time you learn when I stepped right leg first, now we go in different way. My left leg going first and right leg going second. This way is good too. Here we have very interesting move. We call it roll. I suggest to use it after a punch or after a cross. Cross, jab, whatever he wants to do, what you do? You just grab his arm and your another arm is going behind his back or grab his neck. So your right leg going between his legs and step here. So now you just have to foul. Fall on the floor and do like you do usually roll, like you want to just play around. And when you be on the bottom, your left leg have to push his body up. This is a way to push him away from you, and this is a way you can take him down. Right. And here we have perfect position to finish him. There are several different ways to do same roll. The first way, when you go up to his neck, and after all, you will be able to finish him by choke. In another way, if you grab to this arm, you will be able to finish him by choke, but you're going to use another arm. Watch. Here we have perfect another technique. We call it foot sweep. Everybody can use it. Even a little girl can defeat a big guy, and a big guy will not understand how this happened, how he fell down and maybe broke his face. So how to do this? The first thing you have to do, fake. You pull him on yourself, and he's doing step right now. Watch. And this step, you have to kick it. And right now we have perfect position to finish him by ankle lock. Here a couple more different ways to do the same thing. The first one, if your opponent trying to use a jab, he fall fast and perfectly. The second one, I did on UFC number 6 against Mr. David Benatar. So it's a little bit different. Right now, if before you use this part of your leg, right now you have to use this part. So the basically this is the same thing. Right now we're going to learn very interesting move, very effective, and it looks good on TV. I have used it in my movie Total Force. I killed a zombie by this move. So now we're going to learn how to do this. If your opponent attacked you, what you're going to do? You're going down and put your knee, right knee between his legs, and your left knee have to stay up. Now what you do? You just bring your body up a little bit, enough to bring him up. Right now he lost control. Now what you need to do, you just need to turn him and he will fall down. Watch. So right arm is going down, left arm is going up. And now we'll be able to finish him, whatever you like. He doesn't have arms right now to tap up, but it's okay. Right now, and one more way to do this move, but it's very good for a movie. It looks very good, and if you are an actor, you will impress your producer for sure, and you will get the best part in another movie. So let's learn. Looks the same, exactly the same, but I'm in standing position. So what I suggest to you, the first thing, not your back muscle has to work, your legs has to work. Your back has to be always straight. When you go down, your back still straight. It looks beautiful, and you don't spend a lot of energy. And
In real fight, when you drop him from this high, he can break a spine, he can break whatever he has. I even don't want to try to do this. I want to save him for next month. Name of this gorgeous move is scissors. So now we're going to learn it step by step, because it's very hard to learn it right away, all move together. I suggest to learn it like that. You go on the ground, and now, watch. Your left leg has to kick his chest. Your right leg has to kick his feet or knees behind. So the both way is good. Now, you get up and try. Now you can pick up his leg and finish him by ankle lock. The next move is real dangerous for your life. Let's do it. Yes. Left arm going under his head. Right over his head. And when it's going, it's turning it like this. This way. So we lock your arms. And now the right elbow is going down. Stop, 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 stop. It's not a pain. Pain is going to be in a few seconds. Just wait. And left elbow going up. So together it works like this. Now you can scream like you want. Next choke, we can do only if we have a partner with the gi on or with the jacket. First, your left arm has to grab him right here, and right is going a little bit high, right here. And now, don't worry about just a fall down, but not only fall, you have to rotate all your body. So it's going to look like that. Next move is choke, but it's a pretty special move right now because of I have penis on, so we can do it only if we have something to grab on your leg. Watch how it's going to do this. This leg's going over, and this arm, right arm and right legs. We're using only right arm and right legs. This arm and this leg just to control his body and his another arm. So we have to grab all your own pants. And right now, your elbow turn it this way, and we squeeze it together. Right now we have a perfect move, but one bad thing, we can use it only if we have pants on. Pay attention to this hold. Left hand below this right hand. So I will pull him this way, and now my elbow is going over his head, and I'm falling down right under him.
Here we have a perfect choke. Very tight. Tight enough to choke him out.
Right, next is choke.
How we can get it? This knee has to work like arrow. Has to go through his body and be right here. For this, we're gonna push, not really push, we're gonna pull him. We're gonna pull him here, and now watch. So right now we have this leg here, and this leg's go over, we go across, you know. We
I'm
have
sorry
it.
That I'm sweating, but it's a good workout with the best. I went all over the world. I'm Gene LaBelle, chairman of the board of Gene LaBelle's World Grappling Federation. I wanted to get the very best in my federation, and I have got the Russian bear, Oleg. Oleg, I want to thank you. I have learned so much. I won't tell them where I had to go to get you, because as you know, I went to many different countries, too many to mention, but I've got you. You're here. You belong to the world. Now let's go and have some good Russian vodka.
Yeah, and thank you, listen. All right, now the most interesting parts of arm locks. Fly number. Everybody wants to know how to do this. Everybody from a fighter to the actor. Because it looks good on TV and it works. It really works in real life and real fight. So once I did it by in a samba competition. I was really, really sick. I was really, really tired. And I had no power to finish him, to bring him down and continue work. I just jump and I just finish him by arm lock. It was good. So everybody can do it. Let's go forward, let's start learning this. So the first thing, you have to jump as high as you can. And your right leg has to be on his chest right here. And left leg has to go over his head and be right here. So we have same arm lock like you already know, like you already learned probably, but we have it in the area. So that's not a big difference for us, right? So I will try to do very slow, and I will ask Andre to hold 220 pounds in the air, if you can. We can do it. Come on.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. You see right now, this leg is going over, and my head's going between his leg, and I'm still control his arm. And now my legs bringing him down, and we have typical arm locks. Let's finish. Baba! We're gonna learn double arm locks. Watch. Your legs is going over his head and across right here. And right now what we need to do, we need to keep his arms on your chest. And when you lock your legs, squeeze it together, and at the same time, try to pull arms in a positive size, like this. So, this works very well. You see how simple is it? Your partner expects from you to do something difficult, something with the turn of your body, or just a regular move like we already saw on TV on the UFC championships, but that, nobody saw this, I'm sure. Watch how fast is it. Yeah, that's it. Let's do it. Here we have a basic arm lock. But what I will show you is not the basic. I'm sure not many people saw that before. So let's start to repeat the basic. You already know. First position, make it tight. Wait till you are a man. Come on. Yes. And most important to control his body in the same way. So your legs has to go like this, lock, and you have to squeeze it like this, very tight. So for real fight, I want you guys to practice just to control his body
in the same position, just by your own legs. If you can do it like for a couple, 3 minutes, means you are in good shape, and we will be able to start learn something else. So let's think you guys strong enough, and we will start learn something else. Okay, one more thing. This elbow will go under my ribs, like that. So that's not gonna move. You're gonna be very tight. And right now, I'm just pulling it like this, and it's very easy for me to unlock it. Much easier than if I'm pulling it like just in the usual way. Okay, let's repeat again. This is end of your ribs, and this is his elbow. Pull his elbow like this. And now it's going in basic way. You're not gonna spend much energy. Okay, another way to do, it's a kind of fake. Let's make him feel, think that I'm gonna do arm lock for this arm. I will bring it very tight, and I will try to break it. But it's pretty hard. And when I see he already not, he has not strong hold, this is time for me to go. Okay. Number four, when we use a leverage, I will put my hand on my leg. So right now I will show you how it looks like. Exactly like this. Not like that, not like this, like that. Yeah. So, and move your body to his legs. You see how easy it to do right now? Try again. Hold it very strong. I don't use much energy. I just trying to bring his arms over my leg. Oh. You see? Big difference right now. And I can finish him. Another way, if you let him to go and grab to his leg, right here. It's a fake. He thinks he really, I really let him go, but it's not real. So now he's trying to get up, and this is the moment for me to use my another leg. I'm doing kind of neck lock. And here we have the same arm lock. Again, I think this was pretty new for you. Another way, we can do arm lock and make it together with the choke. Not really choke, let's call it neck lock. So right now my leg is bringing his head up, and he doesn't feel good right now. Do you?
No.
Yeah. And so this is the time for you to start. He doesn't know what he wants to defeat. He feels pretty uncomfortable here. He doesn't feel comfortable here. So we have best advantage to finish. All right. Another way, remember I told you use all parts of your body. So let's use your own weight. What's going to be if I sit on his chest? Feels not so good, right?
Right.
So I will put my arm here, keep a balance, so it's not gonna bring me inside. Just I will stay here because it's comfortable for me. So what we have right now? Right now we have all my weight works against him. I can do kind of jump like this. Especially if I hear how he breathes. When he breathes out, I have to push. He breathes out, I push. Breathe out, I push. Nobody can go through this. So right now, we're using back muscles and your left leg. And his head on this side again. Very painful. So I'm glad, guys, you're familiar now with the new arm lock stuff. All right, let's continue learn arm locks. Right now we have very interesting move, but it's not unusual move for you, because we already saw that, but I did the same move, but with left. So right now we will do it down, that's only difference. So let's see how it's gonna be. First, I pull his shoulder down, and my knee is going between and under his arm. So right now I got it. I have his arm. Now I need to finish him. It's very hard to do something like that. So I'd love to have both my hands free for something, for choke or for another arm lock. So I will use only legs. Watch. I'm gonna use these parts of my leg, like we already used my hip to do a knee block. And these parts of my foot is gonna bring his arm up. Watch how it's gonna look like. That's it, very simple, watch. This part going down, this is going up. Yes, that's it, we're already finishing. We don't need to do anything else. Right now, if you wanna impress somebody, you can finish him right here, do some another type of arm locks, or you can choke him out, or do same. So we can do three different submissions in the same time. I think it's good. All right. If you understood how to do this, of course, we can do another way, same move. We'll start from a dead side. Let's move fast. So we already got his arm. Or we got from here, doesn't matter. Again, this leg here, this leg's going over, and my feet again lift his arms up. Yes. This part pushing down, this is going up. And I'm still keeping his body right here. So I think it's pretty simple. Alright. Something new for arm locks. You remember? We have to use all parts of our body. So why we cannot use the knee in this position? Weird? No, not weird. Watch how we can do it. When I kick his elbow, I'm bringing his elbow up. So my arm is going over his arm, and I grab my own arms, and right now we have perfect lock. Right now, I'm just pushing him down. And this is going up. And we can finish him right here. We don't have to even bring him down. So watch again how it works. Now I do just fast. Was not bad. All right, next move I call honeymoon. Actually, that's a shoulder lock, but why honeymoon? Because some wife can do it for a husband if she thinks he cheating her. So let's do like this. His right arm right behind mine. And I'm falling down, my leg going over his leg, and we are look like a husband and a wife. So right now, I will bring my hip up, and I will push his elbow down, and I will control his neck shoulder, and together it works like this. Works very painful. So any wife can do it for her. Okay, now we're gonna learn the most interesting move. I'm sure everybody has been waiting for. I call it leg block, knee block, but it's not really knee block. It's something together with roll. So you guys can choose how you're gonna call it, but it's very interesting. First, your left leg is going between his leg, and it's going very far. And your head follow your own leg, and you do roll. So here we have his leg, and we will be able to finish him. What you need to do to finish him? You need to squeeze your own leg like this. It's already painful. And you have to pull all leg. And right now, I'm be able to break it. So you, of course, will be able to break it too. So let's just try to learn. Now, I will show you why the best way to start to learn this move is right from here. Watch. What we have? We have same thing like we already had. So, return to same position, please, Andrei. This is position we have after I fall down. Watch, my leg between his legs, and I'm between his legs also. So what should I do right now? I'm kicking him right now, and he fall down, and now, like I already told you, we squeeze your own legs and pull his leg, and he will tap out. Okay, right now, guys, please pay attention. Everybody saw this move, but not everybody knows how to do it right. We're gonna learn it on steps. 1, 2, 3. So the one is bring it up very tight. 2, squeeze your elbow, and 3, to turn bone like I do. This part has to be exactly right here. This is the pain. So when we do it together, 1, 2, 3, you don't have to forget to squeeze your knee, keep his knee in the same position, and bring your body down. This is the way to make him tap out. He feels hello, it hurts. And now I will show you several different ways how you can use it, how you can do it. Very effective. The first way, when you already grabbed his ankle, you use your leg. You remember I told you, use all parts of your body. And push his leg over his another leg, like this. And push it away from you. You see, right now he cannot reach you. He cannot try to kick you. But I'm keeping his leg straight and very tight. This is the key for this move. This is when you can be able, I will be able to break it. Yes, this is the hurt. This is the one way. Second way, if you put your leg between his leg like this, and don't put it right here, keep it right here between his legs. Why? Because when you control another leg, he's not gonna be able to get up. Try. Yes. My knee will always push him back. And I have plenty of time to take care of this business. So right now I will do slow and we'll just finish. This is exactly the best way to do this. Next move we call a heel hook. That's very dangerous move. That's why it's illegal on many type of competitions. It's legal in military combat samba, but illegal in sports samba. This is the way how to do it. When you have his leg right here, you pull your arm behind his heel and grab your own hands like that. So, you see, his foot is very tight right here. And now I'm bringing his foot up in turning like that. In the same time, I'm pushing his body away and I'm still squeezing his leg, make it tight, make it keep in the same position. Yes. He feels pain in the knee. He feels pains right here. So he doesn't really know where he feels pain. He just wants to tap out. That's, you can do it, guys. I believe it. Next move is really my special. Not everybody in the former Soviet Union could do this. It was my specialty. So this is exactly an ankle lock. But it's a different way you have to use. You have to use only your legs and nothing else. What you have to do, you put his foot right here, right in the middle, this place. And we also can put line right here. So that's not so far like that, not so close like that, so exactly in the middle. And now that leg is going over. Over like this, and we have lock here. And before we will start learn this part, pay attention what I'm doing here. My elbow control his knee, keep it in the same position. Same time, my hands protect my neck from the choke. But I don't think so many people will be able to choke me right now because of I'll be faster. I already got him here. And I suggest you also to control another leg. Maybe by your own elbow, but this is the way to keep him in this position. So let's come back here. First, what I suggest you, this is, looks like a scissor. This leg we're bringing up, this leg's going down. It's already painful, but it's not the same move. It's a kind of a fake, kind of surprise for him. He already feel pain. And now this is the surprise. My legs is going down that way, and I bring my hip up. And same time, elbow pushing his knee down like this. So you see how it works together. We're trying to bring our body, make our body straight. Yes. I'll be able to finish him, not only finish, I'll be able to break his ankle right now because of I have that much distance I can use. So in a couple of seconds he would to find his foot right there. The next move we call toe hook. It's a still very dangerous move. Watch. You have to grab his foot right here, not close to his heel, exactly right in the middle. So your arm is going between his leg and grab your own arm right here. He already feel pain. He already doesn't want to continue, do you?
No.
Yes. And right now you just turn it like that and still you have to push his body away from you and keep it tight. Yes, that's it. In another way, when you can start to do this, when you are between his legs. So you are grab it the same way, and turn it the same way too. But this part of your body has to control his knee, keep it in the same position. He's not gonna be able to choke you because of, there is no way. He doesn't control your body, he's so far. You see how big distance between us. So let's guys do it. Next move probably we'll call a knee block by your own legs. That's pretty weird, but that's a very effective move, and I'm sure not many people saw it before. So what you do, if somebody trying to kick you and you grab his leg, you just pull it right here so you can control it by your own hand, by your own head, and also by your own shoulder. So it's tight right now. So right now this leg's going over like that, right on his knee. And your another leg going over like this. So what you need right now, just to bring your body up like this. This is the way. I'm not trying to hurt him because of, I can't control right now pain. Especially if we use a different way. If we pull his leg like this, this is much more painful. In another way, you can do it like this. And also, I can suggest you do same thing by your own hands. Sometimes when people got to this position, they don't know what to do. And especially some people like to do something very effective, very original. So I will suggest you to do the special knee block and do it by your own legs. It's weird, but you will try. So put your feet right here, and your feet is going to try to bring his foot up. And you're going to cross your feet, and this is the way you're going to use your feet. Now, watch. I will use this part of my hips. I will put it right here, make it tight, make it, keep it in the same position. So right now we have a move, looks like an arm lock, like we already, everybody knows actually that that move. But not no many people knows that move, but it's a similar. Watch how it works. Yes. Nobody expected this. So one way we already saw, another way, if I am on the bottom and here on the top, please go on the top. And what we have right here, we have exactly same position, but we are on the bottom. That's only difference. So cross your arms right here. You are using same place of your hip and your legs working the same way. Just in different directions. Watch what we have finally. I think it's perfect. The next move is very interesting also, and we call it squeeze leg lock. So, type of this move is, we have something very similar all the time. Something has to be always right here. It doesn't matter what, it's arm or some part of my legs. So let's try the first way. The first way, if we put to your leg like this, and right now I'm going to fall on his body, but I will keep his foot right here on my body. So watch what's going to happen. Yes. You see the distance? If I make the distance close, this leg will be apart, separate. The next move we call squeeze leg locks. It's a very interesting move. And there are so many different ways to do this. The first way, we have his leg right here. And our leg is going all the way right here. And it's going right on the middle of his leg. And keep his foot on your chest. And now what you need to do is just bring your body close to his body. And what we're going to have, we'll hear right now. Yeah, we hear. That's nice. So this was one way. Another way, if you are sitting on his body like this, so my back to his back. And right now, we can use your own arms. And same time, like you're gonna squeeze his leg, you can do also a typical ankle lock. So let's try. Very effective, I'm sure. Let's see another way of this move. Please turn. And right now, we don't know what to do with this leg because we need to bring it up. And after that, we can try to ankle ups or something like this. Why? We don't need to spend too much energy. What we can do, we can lock on your own legs right here and put your arm, again, this part, between, right here. And lock it like I already taught you. And bring it a little bit up. Same time, when you bring it up, you have to squeeze your legs. Yeah. I didn't start to do it, but he already feel a lot of pain.
Yeah? So this is also a very dangerous move. Let's learn it.
Thank you all my friends for joining me today. Thank you for watching this tape. I hope you will find this tape very useful for you. And now, goodbye, everybody, till next time. Okay, now beautiful young Swedish princess is gonna show technique I taught her 5 minutes ago. Come on.
Very impressive.